because of a series of bad choices in life, you have found yourself living a marginal life. And because of that, you're discouraged. Huh. Because of that, you are dismayed and disgruntled. Because surely, God can't use someone like me.
Yes.
Surely God can't use someone with a fellowship right now.
Come on, Pastor.
Or a misdemeanor. Someone who's been to the joint. Surely God can't use someone who's been divorced. Surely God can't use someone who is an ex-addict. Surely God cannot use someone who is an ex-liar, an ex-fornicator, an ex-adulterer. Surely God can't use an individual such as that. You're discouraged because what has happened.
Right.
But y'all listen, as you go and apply for scholarships, and as you go and apply for jobs, and as you go and apply to get into college, and other things that you may apply for, be part of a fraternity or a sorority or whatever it is, maybe some club, there's usually an application process that you have to go through. And in some instances, there's an interview that you have to go through. And because of your past, because of the choices that you've made,
right,
and because of what has happened in your life, to get that job, to get that scholarship, and or to get into college or whatever it is you're pursuing, your past has kept you and hindered you in your future.
My God.
And you have become discouraged because what has happened, because what has happened. You're discouraged because they have rejected you. You have become discouraged because they have told you that you would not be successful in gaining entry into this school of academia. You're not eligible for this particular scholarship. Or we don't want you in our club because of your past. Because what has happened? Because we pulled your credit report. And your credit and all that good. Because we pulled your background and your criminal history, it's not all that good. You've got some things out there that are quite questionable and bring great concerns to us. So therefore, we're going to have to reject you. So here you are, discouraged by what has not happened and or discouraged by what has happened. Wait a minute, last thing I'm out of here. Maybe your story is that there is this great sense of disbelief of what could happen.
Come on.
Yeah. For some, discouraged by what has not happened. For others, discouraged by what has happened. But maybe there are those who have this great sense of disbelief of what could happen.
Come on.
That's why Sarah laughed. She laughed because of what had not happened up to this point. I haven't had any children. And we've been trying. And I'm past the childbearing age. And I'm way too old. But wait a minute. God will actually have forgotten that I'm sterile as well.
Come on.
So there's this disbelief of what could happen. Look at 11, the B portion. And Sarah had passed the age of childbearing. Remember I talked about that season being passed? Remember I talked about the windows of opportunity being closed?
Right.
So not only because of the time that has passed, but when she looked at the fact that, you know what, even if I was 19, I still couldn't have a baby.
Right.
Because my womb is barren.
My God.
Because I'm sterile. Maybe I'm speaking to someone here today that you have found yourself in a season of non-productivity.
Come on.
Sterile. Not fruitful. Sterile. Unable to give. And unable to produce that which is supposed to be natural. Or maybe I'm speaking to someone here today, watch this, who just feels as though you don't have anything worthwhile to offer. But I'll stop by once again on my way ahead and tell somebody that God can make up for the lack of talent.
Yes, sir.
I told you he can make up for the loss of time, but he also can make up for the lack of talent.
Yes.
Here it is there. She says, I don't have the talent, or I don't have the natural ability. I am a woman. And women are supposed to be able to what? Give birth. And produce, she says, but I don't have that talent. I don't have that gift. sisters, what encourages me is to know this, is that God can make use out of your weaknesses.
Yes.
That was your huge shout, and I promise you missed it. God can do the miraculous in your life. Because surely God can't use me. Surely God must have got his finger crossed and meant to send this text message to someone else. Surely he must have meant to send this instant message to someone else. Because God can't take a boy, a young man,
come on.